You tucked me in, turned out the light, kept me safe and sound at night. Little girls depend on things like that.
Hi, I'm Claire.
And hi, I'm Babe.
We're both from ADHD.
She brushed my teeth and combed my hair.
Okay, well, both of us, we started ADHD in March of 2007. And well, basically at the time, Claire was still studying in Melbourne while I had just started high school. And at that point of time, we both felt that Singapore's fashion scene was a bit stifling, so we wanted to provide kind of an alternative route for our customers as well as people who like to dress up in Singapore. Because in Singapore, if it was nice, it was either really common or it was rather inaccessible to Singaporeans, and that's why we wanted to change that.
And also in terms of style, we hope to be able to offer a unique infusion of our interpretations of the latest trends.
Well, it was definitely that we had no experience in the field. Like, basically, we had no knowledge of how to start up. Claire was in Melbourne at the time, so both of us were in different places. I was in Singapore studying, and she was in Melbourne studying. So we had no idea how to communicate except through email or Skype, and that was inconvenient times. We couldn't meet suppliers together. We couldn't discuss designs together. So. That was one of the challenges.
Yeah, and there was also the problem with suppliers. It was very difficult to find reliable suppliers in the sense that we were painfully green, so that made us very easy to take advantage of. Stocks would come if they came, there would be problems. Quality control was quite poor, and we received stocks that were very different from the samples that we were promised, and we were also given defective pieces, and there were unaccounted for pieces, missing pieces, and that contributed a lot to the problems we first faced when we started up. A lot of trial and error. It's also a lot about trying, falling, and picking yourself up, and also advice from people with experience and support from people that matter.
You would hold my hand.
We got to know a lot of different people along the way. We got to meet my father's friends, my mother's friends. We received advice from people who had experience, and that was very, very important because it helped us pave a path that was stable, and we always had to keep in mind that, you know, like, we have to be very grounded, and there was and from that we were able to build a stronger foundation. Well, a lot of it is customer appreciation. We are very, very happy when our customers feedback to us and let us know that they're very happy with the pieces they have, they think they look good, they receive compliments. It encourages us to continue bringing more such pieces to them.
Yeah, and I guess like the perks of being an entrepreneur is that you start a business with something that you're genuinely interested in. So, I mean, like, we have made a lot of mistakes, like blunders and parts, but because we actually really genuinely have a passion for it, it's easy for us to just pick ourselves up. Claire and I, as we said before, there was a lot of trial and error. We made a lot of mistakes, but in the end, we didn't have much experience, but when we faced difficulties like suppliers who didn't really believe in our business or our credibility, we kind of pushed forward with it. We started small.
It made us more determined to change the opinion of us. It made us want to break out from the norm and do something different.
Caterpillar in the tree.
Selling point, it's kind of like our unique, our individual perspective of fashion. Nick said just now, we infuse a lot of our interpretations into our designs, and I think that makes us stand out from the rest because it's our personal style, it's our personal view, motto of what generates our pieces.
Well, we don't really, as sisters, of course, you have all those gobbles, don't steal my clothes, don't do that. as younger kids, we had more calls, actually, than we do now, because I think our mother and our father have brought us up in a way that, they've instilled values in us that, as sisters, we should be together and bonded.
Yeah,
that kind of thing.
Yeah, so we never go to bed at night feeling cross. No, that was what our mom taught us from young. So, we got too many things to tell each other to stay mad for long. Yeah.
mean, the overseas, like you said, it's a very small market, but overseas it's a, you know, it's a huge abundant market. So I think you start out small first when you're unsure and you're uncertain. It's always good to start out small. And especially since Singapore is familiar ground, you know, you have, like, even if it's a very, like, vague idea, you still have an idea of your route and your status in Singapore. And, you know, starting out a small business here, you have a better grasp of what you have, like, resources available, as well as who you're bound to cater to. Wish you may
and wish you might. And for the time being, we're actually hoping to branch out into two other sister labels under the HBV umbrella brand.
It's a lot harder than it looks.
Never let a setback affect you. It just helps to make you stronger, and it should propel you to continue pushing yourself better. Yeah.
Okay, well, firstly, our customers have been really supportive. Like, some of them actually have taken the effort to reach out personally to us to, you know, show support, you know, like, give us genuine, like, notes to show that they care. And, you know, coming from somebody who's just, you know, buying something from you, and the thing is, like, when you see HBV, they don't really see... They don't really see our faces, they actually just see, you know, our model and the clothes. So, for them to actually, you know, reach around that and to say, like, thank you, or to say, like, you know, like, tayo, or, like, just smile to it, like that, you know, that effort and that sincerity is actually, like, genuinely touching. Like,
yeah, it makes it feel warm and fun. And it helped a lot, because there was one point of time when we moved to .com, and it was very, very taxing for us because the website crashed. Everything that could go wrong went wrong. And we had to take a break for almost 6 months. And during that time, it was very difficult for both of us because we were stuck. We couldn't move forward because we didn't have a website. We had to wait for a new website to be done. And at that point of time, the market was getting more and more saturated with each month. So we were pretty much helpless. And we didn't know what to do. And during that point of time, when it was our lowest, a lot of customers sent us emails. They were encouraging us, they were supporting us, and they were telling us not to give up. And I think that played a very, very big part in me and Meg not deciding to give up and just go back to us. Yeah, so without them, HBV would have never ever become what we are today. So we owe everything to them.
Thank you guys, we love you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Give a kiss.
Must have been as hard as it could have been.